A lesson from the book of Zechariah, beginning at the 9th verse of the 12th chapter. And it shall come to pass in that day that I will seek to destroy all the nations that come against Jerusalem. And I will pour upon the house of David and upon the inhabitants of Jerusalem the spirit of grace and of supplications. And they shall look upon me whom they have pierced, and they shall mourn for him as one mourneth for his only son, and shall be in bitterness for him as one that is in bitterness for his firstborn. In that day there shall be a great mourning in Jerusalem, as the mourning of Hadad-Ramon in the valley of Megiddon. In that day there shall be a fountain opened to the house of David and to the inhabitants of Jerusalem for sin and for uncleanness. Awake, O sword, against my shepherd, and against the man that is my fellow, saith the Lord of hosts. Smite the shepherd, and the sheep shall be scattered, and I will turn mine hand upon the little ones. And it shall come to pass that in all the land, saith the Lord, two parts therein shall be cut off and die, but the third shall be left therein. And I will bring the third part through the fire, and will refine them as silver is refined, and will try them as gold is tried. They shall call on my name, and I will hear them. I will say, it is my people, and they shall say, the Lord is my God. Here endeth the lesson.
Thank you. lesson from the Gospel of Luke, beginning at the 41st verse of the 19th chapter. And when he had come near, he beheld the city and wept over it, saying, "If thou hadst known, even thou, at least in this thy day, the things which belong unto thy peace, but now they are hid from thine eyes. For the days shall come upon thee, that thine enemies shall cast a trench about thee, and compass thee round, and keep thee in on every side, and shall lay thee even with the ground, and thy children within thee, and they shall not leave in thee one stone upon another, because thou knewest not the time of thy visitation." And he went into the temple and began to cast out them that sold therein and them that bought, saying unto them, "It is written, my house is a house of prayer, but ye have made it a den of thieves." And he taught daily in the temple. But the chief priests and the scribes and the chief of the people sought to destroy him and could not find what they might do, for all the people were very attentive to hear him. Here endeth the lesson.
servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee we, being defended from the fear of all enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness through the merits of Jesus Christ our Savior.
Good evening. We are so happy to have you with us for this very special Palm Sunday service of solemn evensong. My name is Kate Kress. I'm the rector here at St. James in the city. And we are so honored and awestruck and thrilled to bits to welcome the amazing ICantori choir from Walla Walla University with their director, Dr. Kraig. Tonight, we begin the solemn period of Holy Week, and we invite you to please feel free to express your appreciation to our guest musicians at a simple reception in the courtyard following this service, and if it's raining, in the parish hall right next door. As always, I invite you to visit us often for any of our services of worship. You'll find the schedule of our Holy Week and Easter services in your bulletin tonight. Our services, including this one, are being live streamed. And I also want to acknowledge and welcome our online congregation, wherever you may be. For those of you who are friends of great music, we sincerely thank you for your financial support. For those wishing to make a donation this evening, please use the envelope found in your program, which can be placed in baskets near the rear doors of the church as you exit, or if you wish to donate online, please scan the QR code also found in your bulletin. Your gift of any amount is sincerely appreciated. And now walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
Increase, O God, the spirit of neighborliness among us, that in peril we may uphold one another, in suffering tend to one another, and in homelessness, loneliness, or exile befriend one another. Grant us brave and enduring hearts that we may strengthen one another until the disciplines and testing of these days are ended and you again give peace in our time. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen.
O merciful Creator, your loving hand is open wide to satisfy the needs of every living creature. Make us always thankful for your loving providence and give us grace to honor you with all that you have entrusted to us, that we, remembering the account we must one day give, may be faithful stewards of your good gifts. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
Almighty God, our Savior, you desire that none should perish, and you have taught us through your Son that there is great joy in heaven over every sinner who repents. Grant that our hearts may ache for a lost and broken world. May your Holy Spirit work through our words, deeds, and prayers, that the lost may be found and the dead made alive, and that all your redeemed may rejoice around your throne. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, thine unworthy servants, do give thee most humble and hearty thanks for all thy goodness and loving kindness to us and all people. We bless thee for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for thine inestimable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we beseech thee, give us that due sense of all thy mercies, that our hearts may be unfeignedly thankful, and that we show forth thy praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to thy service, and by walking before thee in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen.
Thank you.
Open wide, O Lord, the gates of heaven, and visit thy people in peace. Send forth thy spirit from on high, that their hearts may be uplifted unto thee. O Lord, who for our sake wast of a virgin born, make holy thy people and bless thine heritage. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and abide with you forever. Amen.
Let us bless the Lord. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all evermore.